I'm so sick of wearing this mask.
It's hot and it stinks.
All the good masks are so expensive.
My dad couldn't buy them all for us.
What are we going to do?
Well, people were losing their jobs. Why won't they just wear them?
Because they hate them.
I hate them.
We all hate them.
But I understand why we had to wear them.
You know, we couldn't get together for Thanksgiving.
Or Christmas.
Or my birthday.
Aww. My uncle died in the hospital, alone. We couldn't even talk to him on the phone. He couldn't breathe.
I can't breathe.
We can't breathe.
It was so scary and lonely when I was home alone.
I'm so glad I have my dog.
I had my cat.
I got a turtle.
You're lucky. God.
My cousin's parents are getting divorced.
Oh no. You know, my family actually got closer.
Really?
Yeah, there were actually some good things to come out of this.
How? You're crazy.
No, I'm not.
How did you get through it? How did you do it?
Well, one of the things we did was we told stories.
My grandpa used to tell me stories about the war.
My mom told stories about when she was pregnant with me.
We told each other stories all the time.
Me and my best friend
can finish each other's stories.
Oh, come on. You two can finish each other's sentences.
My mom and dad laugh at the same old stories all the time.
Oh my God.
Same.
One of my teachers was talking about a bunch of people in the 14th century in Italy, in the middle of the terrible plague, who got together and told stories. It was like the whole world stopped just for them. It was right in the middle of things, and everything stopped and went away, and they told stories. I think it's called Decameron by Boccaccio.
And that book by Albert Camus. I think it was The Plague Years. You know, we've been here before. This isn't the first pandemic.
So what are you trying to say?
I'm saying that one of the good things that can come out of a pandemic is that creative people, like us, can use the pain and boredom to create new work.
Like, from that old, the dude from that old fairy tale who turned straw into gold.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah.
So let's do it.
Do what?
Tell our stories.
So what's the straw?
These things.
Skipping Christmas.
My dad losing his job.
I can't make out with anyone.
Oh my God. No slumber parties.
Depression.
All the good stores are closing.
I know.
Some days I get so depressed, I can't even get out of bed.
But hey, let's not forget those awful days and days of just smoke and fire.
Oh my God.
Like, we couldn't see and we couldn't breathe. Like, the smoke just blocked out the sun and the entire sky was orange.
Sometimes I wonder if people will ever believe us when we tell them what we've gone through.
Oh my God. Do you guys remember when we started online school?
Okay, Mr. Lopez, this is it. Day one, Zoom, Zoom, Zoom. The way of the future. You've got your trusty mug. This has helped you through many, many times. First days come and go, but the memories will always stay. I don't know what I'm talking about. I'm nervous. Okay. Oh, here we go. Okay. Kyle is here and I look good. Okay. Okay. All right. Kyle. Hi. Hey, Kyle.
Hi.
Kyle, hey, Mr. Lopez. I can see you. Can you see me?
I see you too, Mr. Lopez.
Okay, I'm going to speak into the mic. I just want to make sure you can hear me. Is this good?
That's a bit close to the camera, Mr. Lopez.
Oh, okay. Can you still hear me?
I can still hear you and I can see you perfectly.
Great. Okay, perfect. This is good. This is good. We're off to a good start.
Where is it?
Okay. Abby! What? Where's my charger?
It's where I last left it.
Well, if I knew where it was, I wouldn't be asking you now, would I?
Give me a minute.
Here it is.
Sorry, Mr. Lopez.
Hey.
Hi.
Oh, there's, okay.
Mr. Lopez.
Oh my god.
Hi.
Oh my god.
Quiet down.
All right. Thank you. Great. Well, okay. I know that this is the first time that we've been learning online. However, this shouldn't be too difficult for us. Okay. We've been working on our social studies project, the one about Mesopotamia, right? And I think, though, we should address the ongoing pandemic.
I mean, oh my God, you could have gotten my computer wet. Now I'm all wet. Kyle,
mute yourself, please. Are you okay? I can't hear you.
Yeah, I'm okay.
Don't unmute yourself. It's fine. I just wanted to, okay. Remember, everyone, please stay muted until, you know, I call on you or something like that. We're going to figure this out. It's kind of wonky, but okay. Where was I? Yes. This virus is, unfortunately, it's caused several people to pass. So it's important for us to be safe. Make sure that you're wearing your masks whenever you're outside, cleaning any surfaces that you touch regularly. We should be back in school around May, but you just never know with this stuff. So let's just all take care of one another, okay?
This is all fake. My dad works for the sewage collection company. He says this is a hoax.
I don't think it's a
hoax. Maybe your dad's wrong.
He's never wrong.
Okay, all right. Okay, settle down. Please, again, don't unmute yourselves until I call on you, okay?
I agree with her dad. This is all fake just because they don't want us to know.
Okay. teachable moment. What does anyone know what the CDC is? Gina.
Well, I guess the CDC are some people trying to fix what happened with COVID and stuff. Am I right?
Yes, you are. Okay. Can anyone tell me what the CDC stands for? I think I know that. Aspen.
Well, it says here, the Center for Disease Control and Prevention.
That's really good. Did you Google that? Okay. All right. I know that it's very tempting. I'm just going to say this right now. It's very tempting to look up the answers because our computers are right in front of us. But let's just try our best to not do that. And if we're ever confused, let's just name it and be like, hey, we're a little confused, and we'll find the answers together. Does that sound good? Okay. Also, please don't play any video games. I can always tell whenever you're messing around because of the...
Oh my God, he froze. We get to do whatever we want now.
Shh, let's wait until he unfreezes.
Well, why not have a little bit of fun? Okay, wait, does anybody have host?
I do.
Okay, go to participants and click make host on my icon.
Don't do it.
Come on, it's all right.
All right, done, I did it.
Okay. So, I'm going to mute you. How do I boot people? That would be fun. Let's see.
Hello, students. Hello, can you hear me? My Wi-Fi was very spotty. I think I was gone. Hello?
Shit. What?
Damn.
Ooh, you're gonna be a big trouble.
Okay, here's what's gonna happen. So I will be talking to Chris. Chris is super cool. You're in super trouble. That's what's happening. I'm gonna be talking to Chris in a moment. For now, there's an assignment on the Google Classroom. Please complete that, and there will be a quiz for you to finish at the end of the reading. Let me know if you have any questions in the chat. For now, I will be in a breakout room. Chris? Come over here, please. I'm going to make one. And Chris is super cool. You have got... I'm going to assign you to number two. All right. Okay. All right. Hey, Chris, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, how about you tell me about what happened while I was gone?
Well, Aspen became host, and then they gave it to me. And by the time you unfroze, I couldn't do anything before you turned back into host.
Now, how does that explain what I heard once I rejoined, when I unfroze?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Okay. So the whole time you were fooling around, this Zoom was being recorded.
Oh, shoot.
And after our meeting today, I'm going to watch it and see if what you said happened was true. Okay? So, is there anything else that you want to tell me about?
No.
About the swearing?
Okay.
It was extremely inappropriate. And I will be talking to your parents about it in the next parent-teacher conference. Okay?
I know, you will.
Okay. Well, why don't you go get to work and join everyone else back in the room, okay?
Okay.
Okay. Can everyone? Yeah, no, I caught that. Just a reminder to everyone, I know that this has been a really rough first day. However, it's not an excuse to slack off from our work. Okay. So, Aspen. Yeah, okay, glad that you're with us. I can see you when you're playing around. Daniela, are you reading conspiracy theories again?
They're not conspiracies, Mr. Lopez.
Oh, okay. All right. Well, Daniela's gone. Okay. We'll be out of this Zoom shortly. So it would just mean the world to me if we can work for the entirety of this time. And also, I can tell if you're not working. Okay. Why don't Kyle, why don't we just go ahead and everybody just start your packets. Start your packets. They're in the Google Classroom, and then we'll come back. Okay.
Mr. Lopez.
Yes, Kyle.
Aren't we supposed to stay until the end of class?
No, I just just go work on your assignment, and then we'll just go.
Okay. Bye, Mr. Lopez.
Bye, Kyle. Chris?
Yeah, which assignment is it? I don't know which one it is.
Number one. It's assignment number one. This is day one.
Okay.
Okay, go.
Bye.
Bye.
Mr. Lopez?
Yes, Gina.
I'm sorry we weren't acting mature when you screamed for host.
It's fine. Kids are like that, and I'm sure you weren't the one that was causing any trouble.
I was trying to get everyone to be quiet while your screen was frozen, but they wouldn't listen.
Yeah, I'm going to have to go and look at the recording later to see what actually happened, but thank you. Thank you for trying to help.
No problem.
Is there anything else that you wanted to talk to me about?
No.
Okay. Bye, Gina. Aspen!
What?
You playing video games?
Yeah.
Which one?
Minecraft.
Is it fun?
Yeah.
Good. Go. Have fun. Get away from this. Go.
Okay.
What a nightmare. Oh, I hope this is over soon. This is such a mess.
When did I move to Mars? This must be some kind of joke. Maybe it was the guys again. First that stupid bug thing decides to attack the world, now this? Can I have a normal day? Well, obviously not, because there's lava in the sky.
I see you're up already. Surely you've noticed the sky has morphed.
Huh? Oh. Yeah.
It's the souls of the dead spelling out a hex to kill all the little monsters plaguing the world.
It's a bug.
What? No. They're telling me it's a virus. What the heck is a virus? Obviously they're lying. The universe is a deceiving thing.
Sounds more probable than some kind of hex.
Excuse me, are you saying that a virus is this mess that we're in? The hex is stopping all the monsters, or as you call it, a virus. But don't be wrong, it's not a virus.
I was just saying it makes more sense than whatever you were saying.
That was gibberish. Sometimes you need to speak up.
Huh? I speak at a rather normal volume, if I do say so myself.
I see you're wearing one of those silly things.
This is not for the virus. This is for the smoke. Surely you've noticed inside of here.
It's 6-2. Of course we're not fully up yet. And for your information, we have noticed the smoke.
Well, anyway, there's important news.
Lovely weather report. Moving on, COVID cases have been escalating throughout California due to many people refusing to wear their masks. San Francisco, even though not one of the most highly populated cities in California, is definitely home to a significant...
Can you believe this? I get it, people are getting sick, but it's not that big of a deal. I mean, this news reporter has no idea what she's talking about. Refuse to wear masks? That's right!
Haley, what do you mean? This is serious. People like you are the reason for all these cases. You don't wear your mask, you don't freaking care. People are dying every day, yet you continue to do what doctors and laws, mind you, say you shouldn't do. Haley, are you even listening to me?
Yes, and what do you mean people like me?
Darcy, you agree with me, right?
And that's my cue to leave.
My favorite child.
I'm your only child.
Hey.
Hey.
What's up?
Mama just won't wear her mask anywhere, and it's so frustrating.
It's not about freedom, it won't block your air. It's not discrimination, it shows that you care.
Oh my god, I know like just how you feel, Darcy.
My uncle won't listen. He thinks it's a joke, a conspiracy theory. Then he says we are woke.
But it's different with Mama. She thinks it's stupid, and she's making big scenes when she doesn't have to. Like, when she found out the movie theater closed, she banged on the door demanding to see the manager until someone inside called security.
Well, that I can't help you with, but maybe if you and your mom keep wearing your masks and, like, setting good examples for her, she'll finally come to her senses.
Thanks.
Oh, by the way, I've been meaning to tell you, there's this new restaurant in town.
Restaurant in town, you'll want to eat there every day. It's a vegan place, a very vegan place. You won't want to throw your food away.
Everything there is plant-based, and they want feedback from their customers on how they can improve their food.
Really? That sounds so cool. Is there outdoor seating?
Nothing but outdoor seating.
Maybe my mom and I can get a reservation.
Not all of you?
Mama hates outdoor seating. She'd rather you take out any day, then sit outside.
Listen, I think you should just, like, take her. Maybe beforehand, like, ask her to deal with it or something. You can't keep avoiding these problems forever, Darcy.
I know, but it's so hard.
Well, like, I gotta go. But you can call me whenever.
Okay, bye.
Bye.
Hey, Mom. Mom, can you come in here?
What is it?
So, can we get a reservation at that cool new restaurant in town?
The new restaurant in town. Come on, come on, let's have a ball. Masks are mandated.
It's a pandemic.
Outdoor seating keeps the germs away.
Of course. I've actually been wanting to go there myself, so I'm glad you asked.
There's only outdoor seating, though.
I figured.
But I really want Mama to come, and I'll tell her to wear her mask and not to make a big scene and to just deal with it and...
Darcy, relax. I agree. She does need to get over it. I appreciate that you want to go with her. I know you just want to spend time with her.
Thanks. Sorry. I'll be honest with her and tell her the facts. I hope she will listen and not just react.
Thank you. Done. Reservation for 3 tonight. I'll let you talk to Mama about it.
Okay, thanks.
I'm already looking forward to it. This restaurant is supposed to be so good, and it'll be nice not to have takeout for once.
Definitely. It's time to stand firm, it's time to speak out. We can't keep pretending and let her just shout. Hey, Mama?
Hey, Darcy, what's up?
So, Mom and I made a reservation for dinner, for the 3 of us. And I really want you to wear your mask and to not make a big scene, and I just want us to have a good time.
Darcy, I understand that you want to do what you think is best, and I appreciate that you're looking out for me, but I can't promise you anything. If anyone at that restaurant gives me some BS about coronavirus, then maybe I will cause a... What? A scene? But I'll wear my mask. For you.
Fine.
I'll be in here doing some work, and I'll try not to cause a scene while I'm at it.
Restaurant in town, you'll wanna eat there every day. It's a vegan place,
a very vegan place.
You won't want to throw your food away.
Spinach,
tofu,
kale chips,
celery,
pork chops.
Impossible! The new restaurant in town, come on, come on, let's have a ball. Masks are mandated.
It's a pandemic.
Outdoor seating keeps the germs away.
Wow. This place is so cool! I forgot how creative people can get with outdoor seating!
Good evening.
Oh, good evening.
Hi. Do you have a reservation?
Yes, under the name Nicole.
Party of 3?
Yep, that's us.
I'll lead you to your seats right away. Follow me.
Thank you.
You can access the menus if you scan this QR code.
God, can't we just use paper menus? QR codes never work on my phone.
I'm sorry, but we aren't allowed to give out paper menus.
Okay, never mind.
I'll be back in a few minutes to take your orders. We ask that you wear your mask while the server is near your table.
Thank you.
I already know what I want. The citrus and barley salad with whipped vegan goat cheese, pickled beets, toasted almonds, and fennel.
Ooh, that sounds good. I might also get that. Or the charred broccoli tacos with Rancho Gordo beans.
What? I'm not allowed to take a drink?
All right, what can I get for you?
Citrus and barley salad for me, please.
I'll have the same.
A burger?
You mean the barbecue portobello burger? That comes with caramelized onions, alfalfa sprouts, chipotle aioli, and a roasted veggie salad. Would you like to add some vegan cashew cheese?
No!
Thank you.
Your food will be here shortly.
Mama, you can't be mad about sitting out here. It's so nice.
Fine, I like it a little bit. The fresh air is nice.
So, Darcy, tomorrow's Saturday and we don't have anything planned. What do you want to do?
Maybe we can go on a walk and stop by a bakery or something.
Sounds good.
Oh, look, our food's here.
Can you please put your mask on, just while I'm serving your food?
It only takes a few seconds for you to put the food down.
I know, but it's the rules.
We're literally outside.
Please put your mask on. If you don't, I'm going to have to refuse to give you your food.
Okay, maybe I'll just leave then.
Mama, just put on your mask and stop making a big deal out of this.
I'm sorry, but I'm not gonna listen to these silly rules. I'm leaving.
Haley, sit down or for God's sake, put your mask on.
Fine.
Thank you. Oh. Thank you so much.
Enjoy.
Oh my God. Mama, you said you would wear your mask and not make a big deal. What the heck was that?
Everyone is overreacting.
The virus is a really big deal.
We don't know for sure that it exists.
I'm sorry you don't think it's real.
You aren't listening to what I'm saying. You aren't listening to what I'm saying.
Like it helps to wear these stupid things.
You know we all must stop the spread.
I don't understand these silly little laws.
Many people are sick or dead.
You aren't listening to what I'm saying. You aren't listening to what I'm saying.
I can't always stand 6 feet apart.
Protesting it just slows progress.
Why don't they work harder on the cure?
They are working with some success.
You aren't listening to what I'm saying. You aren't listening to what I'm saying. Why aren't you listening to what I'm saying?
Many people who understand just how important it is to find a cure are volunteering to get tested while risking their own lives. They wouldn't be doing that if they thought it was stupid. That proves enough for me that this is serious.
No one has given me a good reason why I should make any changes to my life.
Well, you only listen to what you want to hear.
I mean, so many people are saying it's not that big of a deal.
People all around the world are making it very clear that it is.
I don't see anyone getting sick.
The news channel you watch every day explains just how bad the virus is.
Can't you see how hard everyone is working to keep each other safe?
Remember to keep your mask on when the workers come by. It keeps them safe.
How's Grandma? I'm so sad that we couldn't visit her in the hospital.
Are our chairs too close? We want to make sure you're comfortable.
It's okay.
Oh my God, it's so good seeing you. I'm sorry we can't
hug. What am I doing? It's not about me. I know I'm healthy, but others may not be. I am responsible.
to protect them too. I have been so blind. Can they forgive me?
Guys, I'm so sorry. I've been doing some really awful things lately. If you could help me with this change, this very, very big change, I would really appreciate it.
You have a lot to learn, and a lot of apologizing to do. Starting with that waiter, you better leave a big tip.
Why can't I just make one decent painting? Stupid.
Casey? I brought you some food. You didn't want to come down and eat breakfast?
I wasn't hungry.
What's wrong? Creativity block again?
It's artist block, Mom. This feels so useless. Why does this keep happening to me? Am I just a bad artist? I've always wanted to be a painter. I've always wanted to put my work out there. I could blame it on the pandemic, but that's just pathetic. I used to be better with the idea of being an famous painter, but okay. Feels like I'm just not good enough. Like, maybe I'm just not meant to be a painter.
Casey, don't think like that. You're an amazing, talented artist. Isn't this something that other artists experience? Maybe you just need some inspiration to remember how incredible you are.
Thanks, Mom.
Sweetie, I know you've been struggling with this for a while, and I wanted to help. Something more than words of encouragement and reassurance. And you know that famous artist that you love, oregano? Lavender.
Saffron?
Saffron. Saffron Cadell? Well, I have a friend of a friend, and I set up private lessons for you.
Are you serious? That's insane. Thank you so much, Mom.
I'm glad you're excited because your first lesson is today.
Today? When?
9:30.
That's like right now.
That must be her. Casey?
Yes? Yep.
Your guest has arrived.
Wow. You're incredible.
Yes, I know, darling. I'm here. I am art incarnate. Now, let me get a good look at you.
Bye, Mom.
Tell me about yourself. How did you start painting?
Well, I first saw a movie about art, and I really liked it. So I thought I'd try it out, and well.
No. No. This is no good. Let's try this again. Why do you paint? Speak from your heart, darling.
Well, painting is my passion. Everything else in life feels dull compared to it. I love painting, and I think I'm good at it. I want to sell my art, so that I help and inspire others as much as it has to me. I want to make an impact on the world, leave my mark, make things better, even if it's only by a little. I guess that's partly why I came here, for, I don't know,
for reassurance? For the dismissing of all your doubts?
Yes, exactly.
That's more like it. I like you. What was your name again? Cameron? Callie?
Casey.
Yes, Casey. Casey. You remind me of myself, Cassie.
It's Casey, but you know.
That's what I said. Anyways, you remind me of myself, Cassie.
It's Casey.
Whatever. Casey, you remind me of myself. Naive, bright-eyed, kind-hearted. You must picture me as some all-knowing, divine being who can solve all your problems. Newsflash, I'm just some old lady who decided to pick up a paintbrush. You're right, you probably have come to me so I can make all of your doubts and insecurities fly away. But only you can do that. Only you have that power. Now show me what you got.
What I got?
Your painting, darling.
Oh, yes. 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 So, what do you think?
It's a beautiful painting, but it is not good.
What?
Paintings aren't meant to be pretty. They're meant to make you feel. This painting, it has no soul. So what is wrong?
Huh?
Casey, this is an issue with you, not your impressive painting skills. So what is the problem?
I don't know. I guess I'm just scared. I've always wanted to be an artist. I've always wanted to put my work out there. But then COVID happened, this pandemic. I used to be better with the idea with being an artist, but the pandemic has just drained me. My inspiration is gone and I feel hopeless.
Casey, you cannot let the fear of others stop you from following your dreams. I know it's hard, but you cannot let COVID stop you from being happy. Artists are struggling, but you have talent, so don't let it go to waste. Your art will inspire others and yourself. The pandemic has not drained you. You have drained yourself. Now, show me what you got. But this time, don't let COVID or yourself bind you. It has emotion, it has soul, it has you! You don't need to become an artist, you already are one!
Thank you so much, Saffron. This has meant so much to me.
I know.
What are we gonna do? We're stuck in our house till this pandemic is over.
Duh, Mia. Mary, how long do you think it's gonna be? It's only been a few weeks, but it might be a few years.
I used to have so many activities. Now I just eat, log on to Zoom, do homework, and lay on this couch. It just keeps repeating.
I feel like the only skill I have is logging into Zoom.
Well, we can't do nothing forever. We have to do something.
Duh, stop pointing at the obvious. But what can we do?
Well, I have to be in my class right now.
Bye, Mary.
Well, I gotta go do some homework.
Okay, I'll be here all alone.
So the answer to number to B is 27.
You stop touching me. Leave me alone.
Stop. Sorry. Mia!
Finally! It's been hours and my siblings are supposed to play with me.
Mia, it's been less than 2 minutes.
Whatever, what are we gonna do? I'm like so bored.
Well, maybe you should be a little bit more creative.
We can play Pirates and Princesses. You can be the queen, you can be the captain, and I'll be the pirate.
No, I'll be the pirate.
See, you care.
No, I don't. Fine, I care. But I'm supposed to be doing my homework right now.
You can take a break.
Why can't Mom and Dad just buy us a video game console? We could do a lot more with that.
They're bad for you.
They rot your brains, blah, blah, blah. That's just a rumor.
Marcus, Mary, we were discussing something.
Right. Okay. This can be our ship. This can be our swords. Ah, yes. And this can be your crown.
I'm the queen.
I'm the captain.
And I'm the pirate. Mateys, I'm control of this here ship.
No, ye ain't.
I see you got bountiful treasures. The queen's on board.
Stand down, ye unmannered dog, with your rusty hook and your tattered clothes.
I do have bountiful treasures, but the queen could never be yours.
I'll be the judge of that. Draw your swords. You'll never defeat me!
I will! And I will do it now!
Yay! Arrgh! I didn't think pirates could be so exhausting. We can't do this all the time.
Come on, Mary. You know you want to play again.
See? Apologize to Mia.
Fine. I do want to play.
But fine.
Ships ahoy!
Y'all can take your masks off. The mandate's lifted. It's okay. I'm vaccinated.
I saw that sign outside of your window. You're closing?
Oh, yeah, I'm packing up. Preparing to close forever.
What? Why?
Well, there's no business since the pandemic. Plus, I can't keep the shop in shape because I'm the only employee. People don't want to come in a beat up old flower shop. I'm barely making the rent.
But you can't close now. This place has been here since I was a kid, since your dad used to run it.
I agree. Isn't there anything we could do?
Oh, I appreciate it, you all, but I'm afraid there's no hope. Don't be so down, though. Had to happen eventually.
This can't be the end, though. There has to be something to do.
Well, I've thought through all of my options, and there's absolutely nothing I can think of. Unless you two can come up with some miraculous idea, then I don't think I'm staying open.
Well, Elise, have you ever thought of using social media to reach customers?
I have tried, but I don't know how to work this stuff. I could barely get the thing to turn on.
Wait! I think I heard a friend say that he knew someone who could make websites. Let me call him. Hello? Gary? It's me, Mia. I was wondering if you could give me the number of that friend who makes websites. Your friend Ellen? Okay, thanks so much. Have a wonderful day. Goodbye. Hello? Ellen? Hi, my friend Gary told me to call you. Do you know how to make websites by any chance? Your friend Robert? Okay, sorry for the bother. Bye. Hello? Robert? Your friend Ellen, who's friends with my friend Gary, told me to call you. Do you know how to make websites? Your Uncle Ralph? Okay, bye.
Thanks for trying, you all, but I don't think it's gonna work.
Maybe call the last number. It might be the one.
Okay. Hi, Ralph. Your nephew Robert, who's friends with Ellen, who's friends with my friend Gary, told me to call you. Do you know how to make websites?
You do?
He's the one, guys! Okay, what were you saying? Oh, it's that easy? Thank you so much. Have an amazing day. So, Elise, where's that computer of yours?
You're looking right at it, kid. Let's see if I still know how to turn this thing on.
Oh, hell no. Let's use mine.
What in tarnation?
It's a laptop, honey.
Give it here. Watch this, Elise.
Oh, wow. Thank you all so much. Let's do this.
What's a good color scheme?
How about blue?
Blue and white, like my wedding theme.
add that there. Title up top. Address. Name. Almost there. Perfect. How does this look?
That looks great.
That looks fantastic. I don't know how you kids do it.
Well, all that's left to do is to press enter to create the site. Elise, would you do the honors? It's live on the web.
Now what?
Who are we marketing to?
Oh, well, I've always wanted to market to the Ebony Retirement Center, the one across the street. I have a few friends there who always complain about their families not bringing presents.
That's a great idea. Maybe we can email the website to the center, and then they could forward it to the family, so then they could get presents for the elderly folks.
Well, I'm not sure what some of that means, but it sounds great.
I'll forward it to the Ebony home. Wonderful, it's sent.
Let's prepare the shop for business.
You don't know how much this means to me.
So glad we can help. It's an honor.
Where are the customers?
I don't know. They should be here by now.
Is this the flower shop?
It is! Is there anything I can get for you?
There sure is. Can I get a bouquet of those and... those?
Thank you. Thank you.
Funny, I just got an email from the old folks' home. I never knew there was a flower shop here. My grandpa loves flowers.
Her father founded it 60 years ago.
No kidding.
I'm so glad we could be of service.
Thank you.
Oh, that'll be $30 and, 50 cents.
Oh, right. Here you go.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Keep the change.
You all, I am beyond grateful. You two get free flowers for the rest of your lives.
Thank you so much, Elise. It was our pleasure.
Oh.
These phones these days, you need your whole face just to get in. Lord have mercy. Oh, it's Lindsay. On my way. Okay. Send. Send. Lindsay? Lindsay, did you get my message? Come on in. Lindsay! It's so good to see you.
Don't worry, I'm vaccinated.
Come here.
Good to see you.
Oh my goodness, it's so good to see you. Close the door, you're letting the draft in.
Okay.
Are you ready to get going? We should probably head out soon.
Don't forget your mask.
My what?
It's the whole reason why we haven't seen each other in forever.
We haven't seen each other because of a mask?
You really don't remember? It's COVID. That's why you had to stay inside and my dad has been bringing you your groceries.
Oh, yes, of course. I remember, but...
Okay.
What is COVID?
It's a deadly virus that's had us in quarantine since 2020.
It's 2020? Oh, I thought it was 2002.
It's actually 2022, Grandpa.
That's too many twos. Oh, no wonder that boy was yelling at me the other day.
Wait, what?
Oh, never mind. I'll go get my mask. You just wait right here.
Okay.
Oh, Lindsay, you can have a butterscotch cookie if you'd like, and I can't find my mask, but it was somewhere. It's here somewhere. Hold on. Yeah. The red Skittles are mine, okay?
Okay.
All right. I'm ready.
Not that kind of mask. Like a medical mask.
A what?
Here. Have one of mine.
Oh, you hold that, please.
Okay.
Can you hold this, too?
1 second.
Thank you. Lindsay? Lindsay? Lindsay, I can't see you. Where are you? Lindsay?
Not like that, Grandpa. Try again, okay?
Okay. Hi. Now I can breathe. I can see. All right, let's get going.
Not like that either.
Like what?
Here, let me show you. You take one loop.
One loop.
Take the other loop.
Another loop.
Put them on your ears. Pull it up over your nose. Pinch it. Then boop.
Boop.
Yeah.
Okay. This works. All right.
Yeah,
well, let's get going. It's kind of chilly. Can you grab my jacket, please?
Yeah.
Thank you so much. Yeah. Don't be afraid of it. Here you go. Thank you. So what do you want to do when we get out there?
I don't know. Maybe we can get some dinner or something?
Maybe. I heard there's a really good ice cream shop that's about to open, so let's go check it out. Oh!
Oh, my God. Grandpa, are you okay?
I'm fine.
Okay.
I must have slipped because I forgot my glasses, but here they are.
Okay.
All right. Now we're ready to get going. Let's go ahead and go. Oh, Lindsay, I can't do it.
I can't do it.
No. No. That's it. I'm too old. I'm too feeble. Lindsay, I'm scared. I don't understand what's going on. I don't know who COVID is and why he's taking my friends, but I don't want to meet him.
Look at me. Look at me, okay? There you go. Do you remember how to put your mask on?
I think so.
The loops here?
I take the loop and the other loop. I put it on my ears and I make the boop.
Yeah. Right. Let's get going.
Okay. Can you help me?
Here we go. Okay, you can do this.
Lindsay, I'm scared.
Don't worry, okay? I'm gonna be here the whole time.
Are you sure?
I'm sure you can do this.
Well, let's get going. The ice cream isn't gonna eat itself.
Okay. Good grief.
To agree.
You guys were watching a movie?
You were? Yeah. Were you not?
Well, if you guys are bored now that the movie is over, how about we play a game?
Yes. Let's play Skeletons in the Closet.
Okay, sure, but how do you play?
So basically, we go around in a circle and we tell each other our deepest, darkest secrets.
Okay. We can play, but
everybody has to be okay with it.
I can't do anything right. I am unwanted. Everybody hates me. I am not enough. I am alone. I have no purpose in life. My friends hate me. I am invisible. Am I a bully? I am alone. Nobody really loves me. I can't be loved. Nobody likes me. I am annoying. Stupid. A mistake. I am alone.
Veronica, are you ready?
Oh, is it my turn? Am I going first?
Come on, tell us. I'm sure it's not as worse as ours.
Veronica, you don't have to tell them if you don't want to.
Hold up. Tell us what? Now you have me interested.
It's okay, V. You don't have to tell us if you don't want to.
It's fine. The sooner I speak about it, the better. Am I right? Anyways, so I need to start the story all the way back in 2020.
2020, the beginning of the pandemic, right? That was so long ago.
Yep, so I need to start the story from there. It was December of 2020, and I had been in online school for 5 months, but things were starting to get stressful, and I had just started a terrible habit I still do to this day.
Veronica!
Yes, Mom?
You need to stop pulling out your hair. It's getting everywhere, and it's worse than the cat shedding, for crying out loud.
Sorry, Mom.
And have you done your homework? I don't want to see any grades below an A. Do you understand me?
I understand, Mom.
I know you're in seventh grade, but if you want to get into a good high school, you have to work for it. Don't walk away from me, Missy. This isn't over. What do you think is so funny, huh?
Just that you think Veronica is failing is funny to me. She seems to be passing with flying colors, or maybe that's just me.
Well, you are a eighth grader, a straight A student, and you're not pulling out your hair like Veronica. So you wouldn't know what I have to do for just one of you.
Didn't you ever think that maybe Veronica needs to see a psychiatrist?
That's a good idea. I'm gonna go and set that up.
I went to the appointment, and I was diagnosed a teen. But things started getting serious a few months later. Hello? Can you hear me? Hello?
Mama! The Wi-Fi went down again!
Damn it, now I can't type my essay.
Oh my goodness, everything's
gonna
get
lost. Did I just get
kicked
out of a meeting? What? Did the power just go out?
No! My computer's only at 2%! No, everything's gonna get lost.
Mama's gonna kill us! Just calm down.
We're not gonna be able to do anything.
Finn, let's go see what we can do.
Mom! Are you?
What do you think I am?
I don't know.
Well, let me tell you then.
She's your doubt.
Your doubt.
She is your pain.
Your pain.
She is all your dark thoughts.
Dark thoughts. When you think you can't do something. When you lose someone special. When you are let down.
She is what you're too scared to reveal.
Too scared.
She takes more than you want her to.
Take more.
She is
a part of you.
I am you. The judgmental part. The angry part. The jealous part. The bad part.
If you hate me,
hate me,
hate me, you must hate yourself
too.
How did you know?
All of your thoughts? Simple. Because I am nothing more but a figment of your imagination. Now, the power's back up. I should get going.
Whoa there, Veronica. Are you okay? You were talking to someone or something, but there was no one there.
Yeah, that was really creepy, to be honest.
I'm just fine. I just think I'm a bit tired.
I wish she knew when to ask for help.
Yeah, I just hope that she learns that before it's too late.
Unfortunately, I needed more than a simple nudge. I would need the biggest push of my life.
You know you can't get rid of me. You don't want to get rid of me. Part of you even likes me.
No! No! I don't like you! I don't want you here! I want you to leave!
Well, then if you want me to leave, then just leave. Leave this world. It's the only way to get rid of me and to stop you from hurting others.
You mean, like, die?
That's exactly what I mean. Oh well, looks like you've been saved for the time being. I shall be off for now. Goodbye.
Hey, you... Whoa there, Veronica. Are you all right?
Sorry, wait, don't answer it. It's a stupid question, but... If you want to talk to your friends about how you feel and what happened earlier and all this, you should. It might help. Who knows? You can't do this on your own. So me and the rest of the family have your back. Remember that.
Thanks.
And if you need anything, I'll be around.
Okay.
Do you need anything?
I'm good.
I'll be downstairs.
What am I thinking? People think I'm crazy if I tell them this. I have to get rid of it on my own.
Good. He's gone. Now I can come back and speak with you again.
Why are you even here? Just leave me alone.
Why should I? I have you a stammering mess, and yet you can't even ask for help. I have you so messed up. My job is going smoothly.
I don't need help. When I'm upset.
Why, of course.
Of course.
Well, then all I have to do is act happy and you'll go away.
Very well. You can try, but it won't do you much good.
Try, try, try.
Well, I'm happy I figured out how to beat you. So leave.
As you wish.
Well, I tried that. And it didn't help much. It only made me more upset and more stressed than ever. That's when things started getting serious. Stop! Stop! The figure is picking on me again. Stop!
The what?
Marcus!
What, Mom?
Marcus, get over here!
I said, what, Mom?
You good?
I'm fine.
Yeah, I'm gonna go call my friends. I can be here for you if you want, but I'm gonna go call them.
I'm fine, you can go.
Okay.
Stop it. Stop.
Well, now that we're alone, I have an offer.
What is it now?
Look at how everyone leaves you. They're better off without you.
I'm losing people because they were fake friends.
Really? Is that why you lost your best friend? Because she was a fake friend?
No.
I mean, think about it. You practically ruined her life. I mean, she was already in the gutters, but wow, you sent her even below that.
But...
Well, then think about it. You deserve 10 times worse. Karma always finds its way to get to you. So, you should take your own life and spare everyone the trouble.
Leave this world.
What kind of plans do you have in mind?
Oh, I have so many. I bet you would just love.
That night, I almost committed suicide, but I didn't. I was too scared. The figure called me names for it, but I didn't care. My family eventually found out after a couple more suicide attempts. Suddenly, all eyes were on me.
Hey, are you okay? Do you need anything?
I'm good. Thanks, Mom.
Okay, let me know if you need anything. Anything at all right?
Thanks.
Oh, your siblings did some digging on a therapist for you and found her. Apparently she's good, so give her a call. You need it, okay?
Thanks, Mom. Tell the others I say thanks too.
Of course.
If I put my mind to it, I can do anything. I am wanted here and now. I have people that love me. I am enough. I am not alone. Hello? Hi. Oh, my name is Veronica. Veronica Sykes. I was wondering if I could set up an appointment. Oh, Judy Smith? Yeah. Mm-hmm. So Thursday, 3:30? Okay. Thanks. Have a great day. Bye.
Your life means something. Your friends are true friends. People see you for who you are. Your friends value you. You are enough. You are not alone. We have so much love to give. We deserve to be loved. Our friends see the good in us. We are unique, worthy, lovable. We are enough. We are not alone.
That's how it started. I went to see Judy, and she helped me. She helped me get rid of the figure, and she helped me find out what it was.
What was it? It just seemed so unnatural and just wrong.
Because it was. It was all of the insults and doubts. It had just piled up in me and turned into that thing. But the past is in the past,
and I'm glad that I told you. Now, I'm gonna get some new popcorn for our next movie. We should watch La Llorona next.
I just offended you and this is how you treat me?
Now we should watch it. It could be fun. All right, I've got the popcorn.
Ay, señor, por favor, sálvame ahora.
Let's start the movie.
So many stories.
So many.
And it's not over yet.
God, I just want it to be over. I want to forget all about it.
No, you don't. These are our stories. We are a part of history.
Like Anne Frank. She was our age, remember? And while she was in that secret hiding place, she wrote down her stories.
Oh, the Diary of Anne Frank.
Yeah, but we're not hiding from the Nazis, just that stupid virus.
No, but she had stories to tell.
Stories?
Like ours.
Just like ours.
Thank you.